Hey everyone, welcome to another video on Mad Over Exploring. We are in Lake Tahoe, the largest alpine lake in North America. We'll be showing you things you should be doing when you're here, but more importantly, things you should not do when you're here. So let's get this thing started.
A crazy couple of days here at Lake Tahoe. We made a few goof ups and realized that there were some things that we shouldn't have done.
That's right, we are at our last spot right now. From all the mistakes that we've learned, we've jotted down some helpful tips that will help you plan an awesome trip to Lake Tahoe. To tell you more about it, let's go in a flashback and tell you where it all started.
On our first day of the trip, we drove to Sand Harbor State Park and arrived at 9 a.m. only to be turned away.
So is there an additional parking lot where we can park?
No, go ahead, Sand Harbor, no.
Okay.
You can walk the trail in, that's about it though. Starts at incline.
Starts at incline. How long is that?
About 3 miles. So.
3 miles.
Fast forward to the next day, we woke up at 5 a.m. at our Airbnb and were outside Sand Harbor by 7, waiting patiently to make it in. The deal with this most popular spot of Lake Tahoe is that it only has 400 parking spots, and on summer weekends, it fills up sometimes by 7:30 a.m.
We finally made it to the Sand Harbor. Finally getting on the water with our kayak. The best way to enjoy Lake Tahoe is to get down on the water. Don't waste your time driving on the Highway 28. Get down on the water at least in one or two spots, and that should also be enough. If you're interested to kayak or paddleboat at the Sand Harbor, we recommend making the reservation online. There are different time slots available. There are guided tours, there are rentals available as well. Even if you make a reservation, let's say for 8:30, you still have to come into the park at 7 because of the parking lot issues that we just told you about. If you don't have a reservation, you'll have to stand in the walk-up line, which could take several hours depending on the availability of the kayaks. So reservations are highly recommended.
With 65 degree Fahrenheit and a clear sky, it's a perfect day to kayak.
The best part about kayaking or paddleboarding at Sand Harbor is to take your boat through all these rocks. It's pretty cool. The water is even more turquoise out here, and you'll see a lot of pebbles and big rocks. One last thing we want to do at Sand Harbor, which we recommend you do too, is come down to the rocks and soak in some sun and take a dip in this cold water. It looks so amazing from here. The blue waters out there, the beaches, the trees, completely mesmerizing view. If you're looking for some food options at Sand Harbor, there's just one bar and grill. You can get salads, some burgers, tacos, smoothies, so they have a lot of options. Before exiting out of the park, we just thought of checking out the visitor center. Really interesting exhibits out here, and there's also a gift store that we're gonna buy a magnet from.
Welcome to California.
If you can't make it into Sand Harbor, you can do what we did on the first day. Drive to Kings Beach.
Next tip, avoid coming on any long weekends or a federal holiday like 4th of July, because you will find a lot of people over here.
Lake Tahoe is the largest alpine lake in North America. All of this water is cold almost throughout the year. So even though the weather in the city or the towns or the beaches is pretty hot right now, the water is really cold. Do note that you should not be parking at all at any of the permit only parking spots. That includes any of the shops, banks, hotels or resorts around here. And some cars were also getting some tickets. If the parking lot of Kings Beach is full, there's a lot of parking available in the streets inside. Another way to just soak in all the beauty of Lake Tahoe is to stop on Highway 28. There's 20 minutes parking available at several overlooks. You can just stop your car, take the steps down and go to the rocks and maybe even have a picnic, but all within 20 minutes. I'm so happy we found a parking spot as soon as we entered the parking lot. This is new today, okay? This is big. One of the most popular places to visit in the Lake Tahoe area is the Emerald Bay State Park. It's a bay with crystal clear blue waters and some sandy beach area. There's also a very interesting place to check out here. It's called the Vikingsholm. I'm gonna show you what that is. But another thing that you should not do while you're visiting here is not be here 4 minutes before the last tour of the day. That's what we did, but we got the tickets. Our tour begins at 4 p.m. That's the last tour of the day, but tours begin at 10 a.m. in the morning and go every 30 minutes. So plan your trip here accordingly. It's a 1 mile walk down a graveled road
and it has a descent of 500 feet.
Just because we are here right before the long weekend and are going for the last tour, I think we're gonna have the tour all to ourselves. Let's see how it is. Let us show you what Vikingsholm is really. That was an interesting tour of probably the only Scandinavian house I've seen here in the United States. The history of the owner, how she bought this entire area, built this house, how it passed on to the California State Parks was all covered in that tour, and we highly recommend you come and check it out. And now, on to the beach.
Yes. Different than the rest of Lake Tahoe. Over here, because of the bay, we are surrounded by the trees and it feels like a completely cozy private area to come and take a swim. Here, there are a lot of boats coming in and parking and partying around, so the vibe is completely different.
Once you're done at the beach, come all the way up back to the parking lot and enjoy an amazing sunset if you can. The Emerald Bay lookout is just a few steps away from the parking lot, so even if you don't plan to go all the way down, this is still a good spot to stop and look at the bay. We're gonna head back to our Airbnb now, but we just stopped at the Inspiration Point. It's a nice point if you don't want to hike a lot to get a view of the Emerald Bay, although there are a lot of trees, so I wouldn't recommend coming here if it's out of your way. Dinner, we've come to the Lake Tahoe Pizza Company. It had good reviews on Google. We ordered a garden veggie pizza. The bread's quite different than what you usually get at pizzerias. And there's avocado on this pizza. Let's see how it goes. Meanwhile, Chedra is finishing up on some editing. Subscribe. We work very hard. We edit on the go.
Yes. The crust on this bread is so well made and There's even sauce folded into the crust, so it tastes really good. Highly recommended.
We are on our way for the last stop of our Lake Tahoe itinerary, Bonsai Rock. You have to park at one of the pullouts on Highway 28 and just start walking through this trail, which is not really a real trail. It's just some loose sand and a path made to get to the Bonsai Rock. It's not a real point. It's famous only because there's a big rock with some bonsai on it, and I guess Instagram made it famous.
And with that, we've come to the end of our trip. We are taking a quick stop at South Lake Tahoe to grab some dinner. We did not plan to stay here for long because it's the 4th of July weekend and there are a lot of people here. But we hope that you got to learn what are some things that you shouldn't do while you are in Lake Tahoe and make the most of your trip when you visit next time. Do make sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel if you found this valuable. Comment down below and let us know what you thought was the most helpful tip. See you next time. Bye.